Okay, so welcome back everybody. In the previous video, we derived the formula how we can write the bias of a kernel density estimate as some integral, which involves both the unknown density and the kernel we are using. And to make sense of this, we need to understand a bit better properties of the scaled kernel KH, and that's what I will explain in this video. So let's have a look. The plan in this section is to just learn a bit more about kernels. First, let me just write that. We'll need that in a second. So if K is a kernel, that means integral K of x dx equals 1, and K of x is positive for all x, and K is symmetric, so K of x equals K of minus x for all x. That's the three defining properties of a kernel here. And I introduced KH earlier. KH of x is 1 over h K of x over h. That's the KH which appears in our expression for the bias. And I want to show you that is also a kernel. Claim KH is a kernel, and proof, the only interesting bit is the integral. So integral KH of x dx is integral 1 over h k of x over h dx. Now we need substitution rule, say y is x over h. So then we have integral 1 over h k of y, and instead of dx we can now write h dy, and that's integral k of y dy, and by this first rule up here that equals 1. And then the second and third rule, I would say, are clear. So I claim we don't need to prove anything for the other two conditions. Now, let us consider kernels in a bit more detail. So the first thing we will need is what's called the moments of a kernel. So the r's moment of a kernel k is defined to be integral minus infinity plus infinity x to the r k x dx. And if you think back, we said in the previous section, k is a probability density because it's positive and integrates to 1. And these can be interpreted as expectations. And for example, the first moment is the expectation of x for the distribution with this density. And we'll see in a minute that is always 0. And then if that's 0, then expectation of x squared will be the variance. We'll get to that in a second. So this is called the rth moment of k, and mu2 is also sometimes called the variance of k. Good. Technically, there's a zeroth moment, but it's a bit boring, so mu0 of k, let's do that first, is integral minus infinity plus infinity x to the 0 kx dx. X to the 0 equals 1 by definition, so that's integral k of x dx is 1. So that will not tell us anything about the kernel, it's always 1, does not contain any information. Then mu1 of k is integral x to the 1 k of x dx, and this I claim is always 0. And proof, maybe we do it with a trick, so we do minus mu1 of k, and I show it that equals mu1 of k, and then if a number equals minus itself, it must be 0. So minus mu1 of k is integral minus x k of x dx. And now I do substitution and do y equals minus x. So I get integral y k of minus y, and now dy is minus dx, so I get here minus 1 dy. But there's another point we need to be careful about, namely the boundaries here swap. So if x goes from minus infinity to plus infinity, then y goes from plus infinity to minus infinity. And we need to swap back the boundaries, which gives us another minus. So if I swap the boundaries, the result changes sign. So we have y k of minus y dy. I just used this minus 1 to compensate for swapping the boundaries. So no minus 1 and boundaries back in the original order. Good. And now k is symmetric. So it's integral minus infinity plus infinity y k of y dy. which is mu 1 of k, and then we have just shown minus mu 1 equals mu 1, so mu 1 must be 0. So that's how I would prove this, but probably you know the rule, the integral of an antisymmetric function equals 0, k is symmetric, x is antisymmetric, so the product is antisymmetric, so the integral of an antisymmetric function is 0. We could have known that straight from the start if we remember that rule. Whatever, it's 0. So mu 1 also does not tell us anything about the kernel. Mu 0 is always 1, mu 1 is always 0, but mu 2 is where it starts to be. Of k is integral x squared k of x dx. And there is no way to simplify this without knowing k. And there is also no way anything is going to cancel because k is positive and x squared is positive. So we know that will be a positive number. And this number we will need later to characterize the error of a kernel density estimate. For now, let's just record the fact that is the first of the moments which tells us anything interesting about k. Then if we would continue, mu 3 will be 0 again, following the same logic we just had used here. And then mu 4 would be the next moment which contains information about k, but we are not looking at this level of detail, so we are not going to consider mu 4. The only one we are going to use is this one. Good. So the next thing I want to do is to combine these two ideas. We learned about how to rescale a kernel to get a different kernel, and we learned what are the moments. So we can just consider what are the moments of the kernel kh, which is given by 1 over h k of x over h. And that is straightforward. So mu r of kh is integral x to the r kh of x dx. That's how we compute moments. Is integral x to the r 1 over h k x over h dx. Now we can use substitution rule again. So say x over h equals y, then dy is 1 over h dx. And we get integral, so x equals hy, so we have hy to the r, the 1 over h stays, we have k of y, and dx is h dy. So this h and that h cancels. And there's another h to the r, which I want to just take out to the front. We have h to the r integral y to the r k of y dy. And that is h to the r mu r of k. So the r's moment of the skate kernel we can express in terms of the r's moment of the original kernel, and the only difference is the factor h to the r comes out in front. Good. So that's a fact we will need in a minute. And now, in preparation for the next section, I want to introduce a new idea here, namely, since kh is a kernel and thus a probability density, we can consider random variables y which have density kh. That falls a bit out of thin air here, but that will be really useful in the next section. And with the moments, we can understand quite a bit of y. So expectation of y, for example, is, here's a rule, expectation of h of x is integral h of x times density dx. So if we want no h, we can just choose h of x is x. So then we have expectation of x is integral x density of x dx. And for y, we would then write integral y density of y dy, where we used that the density is kh. That's what we just assumed. And this thing you will recognize immediately as y to the 1 is y. It's the first moment, so it's mu 1 of kh. And the first moment for every kernel is 0, we said. Good. Doesn't do anything interesting, but we know y is centered. Then variance of y is expectation of y squared minus expectation of y and that squared. And we don't really need the second term because we just showed it's 0. So we have just expectation of y squared. It's the same rule we had. Now h of x is x squared, or h of y is y squared, kh of y dy is mu 2 of kh. Well, and that's the number which we said earlier actually tells us something about the kernel. So that's some positive number. Good. And in general, by a slight extension of this argument, mu r of kh equals the rth moment of y. Excellent. And this random variable y we are going to meet in the next video. But before you go there, you should probably read again through this section and make sure you understand all of the steps, and in particular that you are comfortable with the substitution rule for integrals in the way how I used it in these derivations. And once you've done that, once you have worked your way through this section, I'll see you back in the next video. So see you soon.